Where is that brush? Where is that brush? Is that brush? Is that brush? I said, where? Where are you, brush? Where are you, bro? Oh, here you are. Okay. Hey, everybody. This is my face before makeup. Today, I'm going to be taking you through how I cover, well, these, which would be my adult acne. I don't really talk about this, but I never had acne as a kid, so I didn't know how to deal with it. So when I got acne as an adult, it just felt foreign and uncomfortable. I'm also just noticing how wrinkly my shirt is, and I think it goes with the theme of the before. I should come back with like a perfectly ironed, fancy shirt when we finally finish this. But the reality is I didn't know how to deal with it. So the first thing I thought was like, get it out of my skin. So I would touch it and I would pop it. And what that would do is it would just spread everything all over. And actually, I've still been doing it. I'm trying to unlearn the habit now, but I'm not very good at it, which means I have some scarring. I have some marks I need to cover up. And until I get my ish together, which I'm working very hard on right now, it's just like changing a lot of behaviors. And it's hard, but I'm gonna get there. I know I can. But in the meantime, I need to cover up a lot of this, not because I'm embarrassed or ashamed of it, but because I don't really like it to draw attention from what I'm really talking about. I feel like when I show my skin completely bare, that becomes the entire narrative of whatever I'm talking about, which is a sad like reflection on how society treats acne overall, but it does. And sometimes I want people to just listen to my words and not focus on my face or my, you know, breakout. One of the biggest questions I have gotten from you, because I do share my clean face a lot in stories, is how I cover up all of this. And I figured, well, I just got a new tube of my foundation that I typically use in the mail. And I was like, I got nothing else to do today. Let's film this video. Step one of this video, you're actually not going to see, and that's skincare. I'm just saying this. It's the thing I've learned at the start of my skincare journey. And we're not gonna talk about skincare today because that is a whole other loaded conversation. But one thing I've learned is if you don't have a properly moisturized face before you put on makeup, it's just not gonna work. So make sure that you have balanced skin, nice, you know, daily moisturizer on, your SPF, all of that done before you go to cover it up. Because if you're actually working on a dry face or without anything for it to grip to from a moisture perspective, it's gonna look not as good. So that is like the biggest lesson I've learned. Again, I'm not gonna show you my skincare routine today, but I'm just gonna say before you step up to try to cover up anything on your face, make sure you've moisturized and done whatever other skincare you wanna do. I'm also gonna talk a little bit about the products I use. I use a whole bunch of different products. This is my go-to for my skin as it is right now with my current routine, but some days it changes. So if my skin is feeling a little bit oily, I use a more matte foundation. If my skin is dry or combination, I use something that's more of a radiant foundation. There's also different levels of coverage in foundation. There is a full coverage, which is literally gonna lock in everything. And that is what most makeup bloggers use because it gives you a flawless, completely like, you don't have real skin finish. I don't actually enjoy that finish. I do use it sometimes for photography, but it's not what I like to wear personally. Today, I'm gonna use a more medium coverage foundation because that's typically what I use when my skin is broken out to this level. But I also use light coverage, and sometimes I use just a tinted moisturizer when my skin is looking just fantastic, as it has not been for a while. So I think the thing to note is there is not one solution to this problem, and your solution may be completely different to mine based on how much of your natural skin you want to have shown through, based on the texture and the moisturization of your skin as well. So after you've done your skincare, the first thing you're going to do before you put on your foundation is to put on a primer. Now today I'm using Dr. Brandt's Luminizer Primer. I like this. It gives me a little bit of luster underneath it, and I feel like it's very light for me and it feels comfortable on my skin. That's why I use it. There are other primers I use regularly. I like the NARS Radiance Booster, which is like, this is a really shiny when I'm doing like a more like a bronze goddess look, especially when I have self-tanner on. This one is really great. Other things that I do like to use a lot, if I'm really trying to do a heavy makeup and I want foundation to really like grip my face, which is like a weird thing to say, but literally like hold on for dear life. I want it to last all day. There is a Milk primer that I love, but that is what I use for like long days of shooting, and that will keep your makeup like real hard. But it is, again, thicker. it kind of feels a little bit gluier. Makeup's personal. And so I'm just gonna go with what I like. And hopefully you guys learned about some products maybe you didn't know about. So I'm gonna take my beauty blender, boop, boop. And I keep a little spray bottle of water just so I can wet my beauty blender. Because before I wasn't wetting my beauty blender because I had to go to the bathroom to do it and it was like too far. Then I would just use like a dry beauty blender, which isn't smart. But now, boop, 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 sprays and ready to go, right? Genius. And I'm going to actually put the product on my face, squeeze it. I'm actually running out. Oh, I better order some tonight. I better order some of this tonight because I am. We praying on the last of the tube right now. Praying on the last of the tube. Okay. So I put a little bit too much on my cheek, but I'll work that down to my chin. It's fine. And then I just beauty blend this into my face. Now, the reason we wet the sponge, just as a fun fact, is so it doesn't absorb the product. So you don't waste product just getting soaked up into that sponge. It's still gonna absorb some, but it's gonna be a lot less. I have all the base on now. And now I'm gonna go in with my foundation. And the foundation I'm using today is what I typically use when you guys ask me what I'm using. So I felt it was the most appropriate. And I literally just ran out because I've been using it so much. So I got a new one in the mail. It's the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Hydrating Longwear Foundation. And this is a shade 150. And that's my typical shade. Now, your shade changes throughout the year. It changes with whether you have a suntan or whether it's been a particularly cold winter and your skin is a little bit lighter because it hasn't seen sun as much. 150 is my like spring before tanning color. In a couple of months, as summer comes, this will not be my shade anymore. But right now, it works pretty dang good. So again, I'm just gonna squeegee it on my face. Bloop. Oh, I gotta get it going. It's like fresh. Whoa! There we go. Okay. Whoa. Now I have way more on my face than intended. I have some on my shirt, but yet this is real life and I wouldn't change it for anything. So now I'm just gonna beat the hell out of my face again. So now I finished kind of applying it all over my face and you can already see there's a massive difference. So we can see that there's still some discoloration to my skin. There's still some problem spots poking through that foundation. So now we're gonna apply some concealer. Now I use a whole bunch of different concealers based on how my skin is and what I'm trying to cover. So I'm gonna show you three that I particularly love. We're gonna use the Fenty 150, which is what matches the foundation I have right now. And it is one I use on a regular basis. But I also love Dior's Forever Skin Corrector. And I actually typically use this with the foundation from Dior as well. It's a little bit more matte and that's what I use. My face is a little bit oily. I also love the NARS Radiant Concealer. I use this definitely when I'm doing a heavier makeup because it just has such amazing coverage. But right now I'm not looking for that. I want breathable skin. I want a little bit of coverage, but I'm okay if a little bit pokes through because I'm not trying to like hide the fact that my skin's not perfect. I'm just trying to make it less of the focus. Now here is my number one pro trick for concealing things. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna spot all my little places I'm trying to cover up. Now here's the trick, okay? So I've spot everything. I'm gonna let that sit for about 15 minutes while I do some basic everyday makeup. Because if it can kind of sit and congeal with my skin, then I can blend it out and it's gonna have a better coverage than if I just went at it right now. So I'm using just Benefit's Give Me Brow to put in some brows. And I'm just doing a light natural makeup. For me, I have two stages of makeup. One is all the way out there, fully committed. And then the other is just like enhanced natural. And that's what I'm doing right here. I don't worry about having the perfect brow shape. I worry about defining my eyes with brows. And I think it's weird because I feel like often with makeup, we're encouraged that like everything has to be perfect. I don't really think it has to be. And a lot of those like perfect touches that we spend so much time on, nobody really notices. You notice, but maybe not everybody around you. And bada bing, bada boom, we've got brows now. And I have to wear brows almost every day, or you know, typically I get them dyed. I have no brows, they are white. So what we're seeing right here, even any color that I have at all, is literally just leftovers from the last time I dyed it. But pretty soon they will fade to white. So I like the dark brow. I really like if you're going for a natural blonder brow, I really like the Bobbi Brown. This color is probably one of the best blonde colors I've found. It feels very natural. Just depends on what you're looking for. This is my go-to. I like the small brush and it's easy for me to do and do fast. So brows are done. So now we're gonna do my eyes. And again, this is all my natural makeup and makeup that I do very, very quickly. And if you want them to stay all day, you really should use a primer. I'm gonna use Urban Decay's Eyeshadow Primer Potion. Again, there's a whole bunch of different primers you can use. Some will make colors pop. Some will make things hold longer. Sometimes they'll do both. I feel like there's a lot of different solutions here, but for day-to-day makeup, this is a good one for me. And I'm just blending it out to the under eyebrow area so it's fully done. Now I'm gonna take one of my favorite cream shadows. It's from Charlotte Tilbury. It's called Star Gold. And it's a really pretty kind of like goldish brownish color. I'm gonna take my finger in there and I'm just gonna dab it across my eyelid. And the cool thing about this that I'm showing you is like, it can be messy as all hell and still look good, which I think is what most people need, right? Most people don't have the ability to do like precision makeup. Heck, I don't have that ability most of the time. So what I do with this is just dab it on the bottom of my lid and then blend it up into the crease. And I just kind of keep blending it until it looks with my fingers, not even using a brush here, guys. And now you can see my eyes are really defined. Very simple. And the cool thing is because it's a cream shadow, super easy to blend, fades out into the crease really well, and you really can't screw it up, right? Like, I put that on in the worst possible way. I'm sure there's people who do makeup professionally cringing at it right now, but it's so easy and you can be lazy and just quick about it and there's no problem. Now, the last thing I wanna do, because it is a cream shadow and I have found that it needs a little bit extra on top of it, I like to take a darker shade and put it just right here across the lids just to make it stay and also make it pop a little bit more. So what I do is take anything that's like a brown color. I'm using a NARS palette from like forever ago. And here's where I'm actually gonna use a brush. She's using a brush, just a standard brush. So I'm gonna use this color right here, which is called Sophia. And I'm just gonna go in and dot it right here at the bottom to just add a little bit more definition. And you can see already that that is really taking this to the next level. So now I have this beautiful kind of smoked out brown eye that took me like 2 seconds and is completely foolproof. And now I've also let my concealer sit for a little bit. So I'm gonna use my ring finger and I'm gonna dab it out. Dab it out. So now you can see a lot of that discoloration is completely gone now. The only place I'm gonna take my sponge, and I just have a little extra foundation here, is just blend out these nasties down here. So now we can see that most of my skin is completely covered. You can still see that the blemishes are there a little bit, but the focus is really on the eyes now because I added a little bit of darkness there and a little bit of color. I'm now gonna add some Perversion mascara. It's from Urban Decay. It's one of my favorites. It's waterproof and this stuff stays. I don't get any under eye crap from it. And now I'm gonna do just a little blush and a little bronzer. Now what I like to do is use a really massive brush like this one. I'm gonna use the Balm Take Home the Bronze bronzer. I don't know why I like this so much. Maybe it's because there's a half naked man statue on the front, but I do. It's almost completely gone. I actually need to get more. So I swirl it around. And then what I like to do before I apply it is just tap it out, because that takes any just like loose particles that would make like an uneven bronze out onto the top. And then I just brush it in. And this isn't about contour, guys. This is bronzer. I'm not chiseling my face with this. Chiseling. I said chiseling. That's not a word. All I'm doing here is just adding a little glow and a little dimension. And I'm putting it around the face like a circle and then just in a little bit on the cheeks. And again, it's not a contour because I'm actually coming into the cheek line. So all that did is just give me a little glow. Then I'm gonna use this peachy pink color. I wish I could remember what color this is. I will try to look it up and put it down in the description. But it's a peachy color that I bought for a matte project I was using before and has really become my go-to blush. It's not too much. It's just a little bit. And then I'm just gonna do it on the apples. Again, using a big brush because I'm not trying to go for like chiseled here. I'm trying to go for a little bit more of a natural flush. And then you can see my full makeup. Now the last step we're gonna do is take a little bit more of that concealer, dot it under the eyes, boop, 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 boop. And I'm just gonna go and just bring this under the eye to kind of just separate it from the cheek line and clean up any crud I dropped under my eye when I was brushing on that foundation. Just adds a little bit definition. So you can see now my makeup is done. I have a flushed face. I have makeup on my shirt. And what look would be complete without a little bit of lipstick? My favorite color right now, and I'm actually surprised that this is my favorite color, is this Kylie Velvet Liquid Lipstick in Charm. It got sent to me by Ulta for a project I was doing with them. And then I just fell in love with it because it's the perfect nude for me and my skin tone. So I'm just gonna put that on. Now, if I was going for a more dramatic look, I probably would line my lips, but I just don't feel like it's necessary for my day-to-day makeup. So I don't do it. I know. Crazy. You don't have to do every single thing. And this is my natural glowed up look. But let's show it off in a way that it deserves to be seen with a little bit better hair and maybe a nicer outfit. Give me 1, 2, 3. See, when you add your hair and a cute shirt, it's perfect. And it literally goes with anything in your wardrobe. That is why this is my everyday makeup. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. It's a little bit different, but you guys have been asking me over and over and over to share this. So I decided to deliver on your demands. Links to everything are linked in the description box down below. And I hope you guys have an amazing rest of your day. I'll check you later and peace.